I imagined that success will make me happy. There's no reason why I shouldn't believe that. I observed that at home. My dad was very successful in the career that he took, and I looked up to him and he was happy. And yes, we were very different in the types of industries that we wanted to get involved in, but I also set out to make a success out of my own career, out of my own profession, except that at the end it didn't turn out the way that I was happy. And in this video, I want to share that journey and a few thoughts that I discovered along the way, as well as strategies that you can employ to live a happier and more authentic life. Lovely to have you here. My name is Kai, and together we can build the courage to change. And on this channel, I do that by helping us make sense of the emotions that we feel when we are stuck, explore strategies that can help us overcome this, and ultimately help us to align our lives with our purpose. Once I decided what I wanted to do, I started working, investing in myself, investing in my career, and of course making some sacrifices along the way as well. Best of all, I really enjoyed what I was doing. And despite all of that, there was this nagging feeling that there is something missing. And maybe against better judgment, I decided to jump off the train that I was on. And to my surprise, when I did, despite all the success, despite all the joy that I had in the actual tasks that I was doing, I felt empty, and that didn't make sense to me. And it was at this time that I really started to think about why we can be successful and unhappy at the same time. And after much thought, I landed on three reasons why this occurs. Reason number one, we are influenced. We can be influenced by our parents, by society, by societal norms, and of course, by our own expectations. This isn't always obvious. I wasn't particularly following, for example, what my father did in his career, and yet the things that I observed, of course, must have influenced myself in my decisions as well. Reason number two is so obvious, and yet I've never really considered it before, and that is that our priorities can change over time. See, when we grow, we change. Very often, we think of growth as something that goes beyond where we are today, and so we follow the same path. But that's not true for everyone. Sometimes we grow to a stage where we change our priorities and we want to go down a different route. And reason number three is that we peaked and we seek a new challenge, and that can come in different forms to different people. Some people just like to continue growing in the field that they're in, and maybe they seek a larger team or a different company. And other people seek out completely new challenges. They seek variety. Okay, now that we know the reasons, why is it so hard to turn our back towards them? One reason is that we consider the money that we spend in our careers, on our education, and of course all the sacrifices that came along with it. Second part is that we also build up a mental picture of our life. We have obligations and responsibilities. Maybe we've built up a plan in our head how retirement looks like, and that would have to change all along as well. And the third reason is that we fear the fact that we have to start all over again. And sometimes there is a fear of failure as well, where we think, I can't do all of that again. Maybe you find yourself in the same situation, and then the question becomes, what do we do? First thing we need to do is address our mental picture of the situation to allow ourselves to gain a fresh perspective. Maybe this is about finances. Of course, it's a big question whether you have the same financial stability in the future that you gained in the past. But I would challenge you on that. How much money do you actually need to live the life that you want to obtain? It's interesting to me that over the past year or year and a half, a lot of people changed their opinions on this. A lot of us had to do with 80%, sometimes just 60% of our regular salaries during the pandemic, and most of us did fine. Most of us used the time wisely to look at something else to learn, to maybe think about another passion of ours, and we were happy and fulfilled, and it had very little to do with the money. So that's a change in perspective that we could gain. The other mental picture that we may have to address is that of purpose. It can be very easy to become fearful of the fact that, hey, we've been unhappy today and now I change, but there is no real guarantee that I'll be happy in the new environment, right? And no, there isn't. But at the same time, you have to experiment, and quite frankly, objectively, those fears that we have usually have to do with people around us. Maybe the people we want to impress, maybe the people who we care about. But the reality is that most people, maybe other than your loved ones, are more concerned about their own life and their own well-being, and they don't spend as much time thinking about your particular situation than you might think. So don't be too bogged down by that. Again, allow yourself a fresh perspective that this can be an exciting venture as well. And of course, then there's the fact of having to start all over again, and maybe you start at the bottom of a hierarchy in a new company. But even then, know that people around you will acknowledge that you've done things in life before. They will appreciate you for it, and the life experience that you bring to the role will give you a jump start. So all of these things have to do with just allowing ourselves to gain a fresh perspective, to put the fears that we have behind us. Strategy part two, anticipate that you will be judged. And yes, sometimes you will be judged by other people, but you will be surprised how much judgment you will receive just from yourself. You compare yourself against the person you used to be, the person who you know, the person who had all those successes in the past. And it's very hard to do when you see that so far you haven't had that much success in what you do right now. But anticipating that will help you to keep in the back of your pocket a list of why you did that change. What are the reasons for it? What is the life that you wish to obtain? So if you anticipate judgment by others, judgment by yourself, and then remember what your purpose is, remember why you did the change, you'll be in a much better situation to deal with the change going forward. And the third part going through this difficult period is also to remain open to adjustments. It's very unlikely that you change and you'll immediately find exactly what you were looking for, to immediately find happiness and success again. Because remember, when you were young, when you chose a job or a profession, sometimes there was a lot of experimentation involved with it. And that's even scarier when you're older, but at the same time, it is also less risky because, again, you have life experience. You have things that you've already done successfully that will help you in the future as well. So please do remain open to adjustments. Sometimes you have to twist and turn. Sometimes you have to go into a different direction. Sometimes you have to go a few steps back before you can move forward. So don't be discouraged. Do some of the things that we've discussed today resonate with you? Hopefully, they can give you a deeper understanding of the feelings that you have as you deal with those situations. And hopefully, it'll also give you a few ideas and strategies to help break down your ideas. Before I summarize, I'd love to hear your stories as well. Please do leave them in the comment section below and maybe even add a few strategies that work for you. Do join me on this journey by subscribing to the channel. And if you get value out of this video, then do give me a thumbs up. It really helps the channel a ton. Thank you. Now, remember, first of all, identify what contributes to you not following your ideal journey. Take time to consider which of the three fears may affect you most and is representing the biggest obstacle. And third, consider the small steps that you can already take today to go towards the life that you want. And if you want to know about a simple change of attitude that can help you to be happier in your current job, then watch the video that is on the screen right now. Look forward to seeing you over there, and of course, in the next video.